Hello students, welcome to the class of editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding in Nepal the politics of reconstruction written by Kanak Mani Dikshit. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2. Now in order to understand this editorial, we need to know about the politics in Nepal. We need to understand about the tectonic political changes that has taken place in Nepal. And we also need to understand the role of the other countries that are interfering with the internal politics of Nepal. Now, in order to understand the present political crisis that is taking place in Nepal, we need to know about the history of the evolution of this political crisis. We also need to know about how the political process it has undergone a change in Nepal. Now as far as Nepal is concerned, till 2008 it was a monarchy, and before 2008 there were phases in which the monarchy had enveloped itself with pseudo monarchy. Means there were phases when this monarchy, it was getting diluted, it was deliberately diluted in order to address the grievances of the people who were looking for a republican form of a government, who were looking for the democratic setup. So broadly till 2008 there was monarchy in Nepal, and after 2008 the republican form of government has been introduced in Nepal, and along with the republican form of government, the multi-party system has also been introduced in Nepal. So Nepal, it is a budding democratic republican country, and in 2008 Nepal was not having its constitution. So all the political parties who have fought with the monarchical forces, they have actually coalesced with each other to form a constitution for Nepal. So in 2008 the election was held in Nepal to select its constituent assembly that was given the mandate to design the constitution of Nepal. To Nepal ka samvidhan banane ke liye ek election hua 2008 mein constituent assembly ka. To is election mein jo teen major political parties hai Nepal ki, jisne abhi tak fight kiya tha against monarchy, they had participated in this election, and the result of the election of the 2000, it had given the clear mandate to the Maoists. So the Maoists, the political party of the Maoists, they have gained the maximum number of seats in the Constituent Assembly in 2008 election. So the second political party that stood second, it was the Unified Marxist Leninist Party. It is the Communist Party of Nepal, Unified Marxist Leninist Party. And the third, the party that stood third in the election, it was the Congress, Nepal Congress. So these are broadly the three political parties that are fighting with each other to design the constitution of Nepal. So from 2008 It has been 2015 and till date Nepal is devoid of a constitution. It is a country that is working without a constitution. It is a country in which the government is formed solely on the basis of the election of the Constituent Assembly. Till 2013, it was the Constituent Assembly which was running the government. And this Constituent Assembly that was formed on the basis of 2008 election had the mandate to design the constitution. But this Constituent Assembly had actually failed in designing the constitution. And again, the elections were held in 2013 November. And after these elections, a new Constituent Assembly was formed. And in the new Constitution Assembly that was formed in Nepal, it is the Congress that has scored the first rank, and the Maoists, they have been relegated to the third position. Now, why there has been no consensus? Why there has been no syncretism among these political parties? Why there is no unison among these political parties to decide about the constitution of Nepal? The conflict, the major reason of the conflict is about of what kind of the federal structure the Nepal should adopt. This is the main reason of conflict. Maoist jo hai wo kehte hain कि जो फेडरल स्ट्रक्चर अडॉप्ट होना चाहिए नेपाल में, उसका बेसिस एथनिसिटी होना चाहिए. इट शुड बी ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ एथनिसिटी. नाउ यू कैन आल्सो ड्रॉ पैरेलल टू व्हाटएवर इज हैपनिंग इन नेपाल विद इंडिया. इन द बिगिनिंग व्हेन इंडिया गॉट इट्स इंडिपेंडेंस, देयर वाज लॉट ऑफ फाइट अमंग द पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज ऑफ हाउ द स्टेट रीऑर्गेनाइजेशन शुड बी डन. And a lot of pressure was exerted on the Congress government at that point of time during 1950s and 1960s that the states should be created on the basis of one language, one state. And n number of commissions were set up to decide about this thing. And the same thing is taking place, the same thing is happening in Nepal. Now, it is the Maoists who want that the entire federal structure that should be designed, it should be designed on the basis of ethnicity. And this is causing a lot of conflict in Nepal. And because of the disagreement, because of the lack of cooperation among these political parties, the Nepal, it has seen n number of prime ministers. We have seen Bhattarai, we have seen Prachanda, we have seen Ram Baran Yadav. So the Nepal as a political country, it is in a real turmoil. Now a consensus should be built up between the main political parties if they want to tread the path of development. And of late, Nepal has also been struck by a grave earthquake, and it has also jolted the politics in Nepal. Now it is the time for the Nepal to work constructively towards a possible and sustainable political solution which can provide a constitution to the Nepal. So this is all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIAS Mentors. You can contact me at 84594-0000 in case you are interested in buying the video classes in the form of pen drive and DVDs. Now, in order to avail the information on the classes that we are offering, you can visit our websites, that is eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com. You can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainiki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. And in case you've liked this video, please click on the like button. So this is all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice, nice day.